Here's my definition of mental toughness. The ability to focus, Michael, on the task at hand, exactly what you said, in the face of adversity, or even because of adversity. One is mental. I'll talk about those in just a second. The other one is spatial, area-wise, and the last is time. If you think about mental focus, when it comes time for you to make your shot, which is the brain that we want to make the shot? Our thinking brain, our emotional brain, or our athletic brain?
Athletic.
Everybody raise your hand, say athletic brain. Yes, we want our athletic brain to be making the shot. So one of the things that you could begin to ask yourself when you get into a position of adversity is, what brain is in charge here? Which brain am I operating in? We want it to be in the athletic brain. I think that people have two tendencies. One is they try to control. They want to control the situation. And that usually means to me that you're in your thinking brain. You're thinking through, well, I've got to have this part, this part, this part, do this, do this, do this, and it's got to be exactly like this, and my club's got to go right exactly there. So they over-control it, and that is, to me, a cognitive function. The control function of cognitively trying to think your way through a swing. We know that our thinking mind is good in practice, but not good in performance. When we perform, we want to be in the athletic brain. We want to turn all of the movement function, the motor function, over to the athletic brain. If you try to think your way through something, you're not going to be accurate, you're not going to be fluid, and you're not going to be very coordinated in your movements. I mean, we've all experienced that, so I'm not going to go into too much detail. The point is that I want you to think about it when you're in the face of adversity. Do a mind check and say, well, what am I trying to do? Do I feel like I need to white knuckle this and just control my way all the way through the swing? That's step one. Step two deals with the emotional brain. So that's, like I said, there are two ways people tend to respond. One is they're going to think their way through. They're going to control everything. And the other is they're going to have some emotional component to it. And that emotion can span, you know, all kinds of the whole emotional spectrum. Anything from, you know, mild fear to anxiety to paralyzing, you know, just absolutely paralyzed with fear about making the shot. So when that happens, ask yourself, I'm in adversity, okay, how am I reacting to this? Or are you beating yourself up, or are you afraid of what may happen in the future? So that kind of relates also to the time part of where am I? In other words, if I'm in the past, generally speaking, if I'm in the past, I'm worried about what's already happened. Geez, I just three-putted the last hole, all I had to do is two-putt, and I'm going to win the tournament, So you're out of focus from a temporal standpoint. Part of your focus is still in the past. Or you start playing along, you're like, geez, I'm on the 14th hole and I'm two over par. That's way out of my comfort zone. Holy cow, right? I'm like, we better double bogey the next six holes coming in, or next five holes coming in, so I can get back into my comfort zone, right? So now you're starting to project forward, or you're starting to count, and you're like, okay, let's see, I'm seven over par with two holes to go. Geez, if I can just par the next two, I'm gonna break 80. Holy cow, are you in the moment? You're projecting forward. It's really hard to stop the emotional reaction. It's hard to stop the emotions from happening. In fact, you can't. The only thing you can do is limit the duration and the intensity. So anytime your brains get out of sync and you start worrying about the past or start worrying about the future, then your ability to communicate effectively with your athletic brain, which is what we want to carry out the motion, becomes impaired. It's what we call interference. First T jitters. So what brain is that? That's causing first T jitters. Thinking brain, emotional brain, or athletic brain? Has to be the emotional brain, doesn't it? So we need a way to get the emotional brain to quiet down a little bit so our athletic body can do it, or we need to sync up just a little bit better to handle that. That kind of gets me to my next one, which is task absorption. So this is one of the three key mental skills. This is what we call a zone precursor. In other words, if you have total task absorption, you are in a state where you can get into the zone. When you are in the zone, this is one of the things you have, total task absorption. That's where we want to be. We want to be totally task absorbed. It's a zone state. So it's one of the key things that we want to have. On the other hand, when we're facing adversity, are we totally task focused? No. Usually there's a lot of things that we start to process, right? What could go wrong? What do I have to do here? I've never been in this situation before. How do I deal with this? A lot of questions. So is that a place where we're going to be, you know, in a zone-like state where we can perform our best? Not unless you can purposefully redirect your focus. That's the idea. Here's the other thing that I want you to do when you take it out to the course. Just be aware, after the shot's over, just be aware of where your focus was during the swing. And for my two cents, the answer should be very simple. Back of the golf ball, target. It doesn't have to be any more complicated than that. Okay, so where does pressure come from? Is that a cognitive idea, or is it an emotional? It's an emotional reaction, isn't it? It's really your emotional reaction to something, usually something that could happen in the future. So if you're starting to feel pressure, wow, where am I? Okay, I'm really getting myself out of the moment. I'm not focused on the task at hand. I'm losing my focus because a big part of my awareness, my thinking brain, is somewhere in the future. I have to do something to get my brains back in sync. So think about that the next time you feel pressure. So the next one, in terms of adversity, is what I call physical. So stance, lie, weather, conditions, your physicalness. But now what I'd like to do is talk about solutions and how do we deal with that so that we can actually learn to become more mentally tough as we go forward. So one of the things that that we learn in sports psychology is if you can name your demon, you can control them. So one of the keys that I think everybody ought to rely on is something we call a pre-shot routine. Yes, we love to have routines, right? Because that puts us on automatic. And so if we can put ourselves on automatic, that's how we begin to ignore all the things that are going on around us and begin to focus on just what we need to do, right? Now, we've mentioned as I've kind of gone along a few of these specific things, but I think there are three specific tools that you can use at any time to help you get more focus, to be in the moment, and to focus on the task at hand. And because we're dealing with adversity and the issue of pressure, I'm going to say right now that one of my favorites is the idea of boxing something or compartmentalizing something. So we have first tee jitters. We're coming up to the first tee. We're a little nervous about that shot. We recognize that we're nervous. We recognize that we're in the future. We put a name to the demon. Now what do? We put the demon in a box. We say, okay, you're in a box and you're going to be right there. And I know you're there, so I know I'm a little bit nervous, and but you're not going to control the shot. And guess what? You're still going to be in the box when the shot is over. When the shot is over, I'm going to come back, I'm going to pick you up, and then we can deal with whatever it is. There's something about physically doing something that actually helps you remember what the issue is. I had some of my students at one point take a ball, and I would have them hold. So let's say you're on first tee, you're dealing with first tee jitters, ball's teed up there. I would have them take a second ball, and I would say, okay, this ball represents all the things that I'm worried about that could happen in the future. I'm going to put you right there. And then I'm going to step up, and I'm going to hit this ball, and then I'm going to pick this one up, and then I'm going to go on and play. It allowed them to put aside the first tee jitters for just a long enough. I mean, the swing only takes a second and a half. It doesn't take very long. You can put it aside for a second and a half. One of the keys, though, to staying in the moment is relaxation breathing. Breathing alone is valuable, but you need to do it the right way. What you really need to do is take deep breaths called yoga breaths or diaphragmatic breaths. You want to expand your tummy. You should have a breath in your pre-shot routine. Most of the time, the big issue is focus. And when I breathe and when I do my relaxation breath and I'm sitting here looking at my target, I'm aware that my cone of focus goes this way. But I use my breath when I'm standing back with the ball between me looking at my target, I use that breath to reverse the cone and narrow in. And as I exhale, I have this mental image of my focus just going shoo, and going right down to my target. And then I'm into my routine and I'm doing it. Second key tool for you to use is visualization. To say, this is exactly what I want to pay attention to, narrow the focus, get the cone of focus going narrow, and if you can see what it is that you want to do, that's another way for you to eliminate outside distractions. So when you breathe, visualize at the same time. See it, and then you get the double whammy. Visualization, extremely important. Third one, Michael, the thing you brought up, which is positive self-talk.